No.
Oh, so sad. I hate to be harsh, but like it's just too expensive. There's others. And that first quarter of 2020 is in the books. What a quarter it was. I'm excited it's April. March was just so crazy. And now we're starting the second quarter. I'm optimistic. I know we're going to be going through some very difficult times around the world in the month of April. Let's hope the month of May is better, and then the month of June even better than May, and we just keep working through this together. But all I'm saying is good riddance to the first quarter of 2020. Okay, everyone. Gosh, I am catching up on a lot of different things through these strange times, and I just tweeted this out. I said only took me 18 months, but I finally aggregated a Hoka One running shoe review playlist on this channel. It only took 18 months. I don't know what I'm gonna do with my time, but upper right-hand corner, in case you want to see the Carbon X, the Rincon, the Hoka Evo Speed Goat in one playlist. And again, upper right-hand corner, I'll also link to it at the end of this vlog. But today we're talking about Hoka. Oh yeah, and I also did it for ASICS. And what was it? Oh yeah, Skechers. Ace. I don't know where they're. Oh, there's some Skechers up there. Over the past couple of weeks. So, but today we're talking about Hoka running shoes of 2020. And listen, this is not. In fact, somebody tweeted back at me, "No love for the Bondi." And it's like I got nothing against the Bondi, but I just had. It's like so many shoes, so little time, as I'm always saying. So we're going over the Mach 3, the Cavu 3, the Elevon 2. And the Arahai, I think that's how you say it, the Arahai 4 today in the studio. And real quick, as far as how Hoka works into my running shoe rotation, you know how I love talking about the rotation, is that I lean toward Hoka, of course, for my recovery days when I wanna, as I put it, kind of baby my legs. In fact, I did it today. I ran in the Hoka Evo Speed Goat because I was going out on some trails, and this is a trail shoe, and I just wanted a little extra cushion to absorb my training from the half marathon time trial on Sunday. So today is Wednesday, so Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and finally my legs are starting to feel better today. In fact, okay, so I did 10 miles, seven, I think it was, there it is on your screen. I think it was about 750, 755 a mile. So my legs are starting to come around. I was maybe gonna go a little faster today, but I decided to ease it. I'm easing back into it after that time trial, and then I will go faster tomorrow. And just one more point on Hoka and the running shoe rotation is that maximalist and high stack heights I enjoy, but I also don't wanna over rely on them because even though it feels good to me on my legs, it might allow me to run more. And is that necessarily a good thing for my training, like basically leaning into perhaps overtraining or doing long runs that are almost too long, okay? So it's a balance. It's all about that balance for me when it comes to Hoka. And yes, this vlog is not my full review of all these Hoka shoes from 2020. Of course, the cards will pop out in the next 7 to 10 minutes if you wanted to go deeper into each shoe. For example, talking about the uppers, the midsole, the outsole in more detail. And let's dive in first to the Hoka Mach 3. If you remember from, I guess, probably 6 weeks ago now, I took this shoe out for a couple runs and did not take it to 50 miles. So if you know, if I don't take a shoe to 50 miles, you know that it did not blow me away as far as the performance. And the reason I did not enjoy the Hoka Mach 3 is the midsole foam felt too firm. And it, I would say, like, definitely a tempo day shoe potential, but for some reason, it just did not have enough forgiveness through that midsole. And also, I was running in the shoe when there was a decent amount of snow out here in Denver, and the outsole was really, really slick. Just really slick. Like, no additional outsole rubber to help kind of grip the roads. So anyway, keep that in mind if you live somewhere where the roads are a little slick right now, or were slick, at least in the past, in the winter. So maybe if you're in a really dry, arid climate, you don't even have to worry about that. But anyway, Mach 3 did not do it for me in 2020. $140 price tag. too much. I think 120 would be a more realistic price point for me to get a little more excited about picking this shoe up. But anyway, sadly, the Mach 3 did not make it to 50 miles in 2020. Moving on to the Cavoo 3. There it is on your screen if you're wondering how to spell it. Interesting name. We're looking at a 6 millimeter drop from heel to toe, 26 millimeter in the heel, 20 in the forefoot. So definitely medium stack height category. So on the lower scale, you know, compared to a lot of other Hoka shoes on the marketplace, 6.9 ounces in men's size 9. That is what I'm talking about, Hoka. That is a solid weight category for the Cavoo 3. And the price point, $120, okay? So less than the Mach 3. So I like that a lot. Now, where would I put this shoe in the running shoe rotation? Oh, man. It's almost coming across... I want to say easy day, but that stack height is just actually a little too lean for an easy day. I just like a little more stack height. You know, 20 millimeters in the forefoot is just a little too low for me. And for this Cavoo, it's almost coming across everyone as a cross trainer. So you go out for your 3 mile jog outside your gym, and then you transition from outside your gym straight into the weights, straight into the plyometrics in the gym, straight into whatever you're doing in the gym, maybe hopping on a bike. It just, even though the weight is really low, I don't feel, you know, one of the points I remember from the first impression is that it, the upper is not locking down over the top of my foot tight enough or well enough. It's just a little too loosey-goosey through that upper to take it up to higher speeds. 6.9 ounces, like that's a tempo day shoe weight category for me. But that's how I am going to use the Cavoo 3 moving forward, is more like, okay, I'm gonna go easy out around my gym for 3 to 5 miles and then hop right into the gym. And now moving on to the Elevon 2, there you go. And that's how many miles I have in the Elevon 2 at this point on your screen. So a 5 millimeter drop from heel to toe, 32 millimeter in the heel, 27 in the forefoot, so that high stack height category. Looking at 10.1 ounces for men's size 9, and there's all the stats on your screen in grams and also for the ladies as well. Now, oh boy, so I put this shoe in the long run category, absolutely, middle distance to long run, so for me that, you know, 15 to 22 mile range, and $160 price tag for the Elevon 2. Pushing it for me, really pushing it there. I'd like to see that closer to 145, maybe 150. 160 is a little much. Now, I will say though, I think, gosh, and again, there's on your screen the amount of miles I have in this shoe. I think this shoe is gonna go the distance. 500 miles, 600 miles, even higher. And you know, I'm not seeing really any wear and tear on the outsole at this point. I really enjoyed the ride in the Elevon 2. It did well through this Hamburg Marathon training block, just getting the miles in, getting the miles in. Now, because of that weight, I did not take the Elevon 2 to, you know, higher paces, let's say like sub 6:30 minutes a mile for me. I hung out closer to that 7 minute to 7:45 a mile pace for my middle distance and long run days in this shoe. Overall, love the ride of the Elevon 2. The upper, very comfortable in the lockdown on top of the foot. What they did with the tongue, and I just to remind myself, yeah, it's a unique gusseted tongue. It's not really gusseted, but it is connected to the outer wall. How they set up the eyelet chain is just unique. I'll leave it. If you want more details, go check out the full review there of the Elevon 2. And I'll let you know if I would buy all four of these shoes again here in a second. And now last but not least, the Arahi 4. Okay, 5 millimeter drop, 32 stack height in the heel, 27. So just like the Elevon 2 as far as that 5 millimeter drop, all right? But the Arahi 4 is stability. So they built in some higher density rubber through the outsole. So this orange here, it makes a J actually, okay? There's the J. So this is higher density foam just to create more stability through your foot strike. I'm more of a neutral running guy, but every now and then I mix in some stability shoes. And I must say, I don't love when running shoes, when stability running shoes have a guide rail or a roll bar, sometimes it's called, built into the, basically built between the midsole and the upper. Usually it sits right about there. I really like what Hoka did with this. And here it is on your screen. I forget the name of the technology off the top of my mind right now, but there it is on your screen, this J that they built in to the outsole. So good work, Hoka. I really, really liked it. And it is coming in, 9.6 ounces in men's size 9 or 8 ounces in women's size 8, okay? And $130 price tag, all right? So I think it's good. I like that price tag. I think lifespan of this shoe, not quite as much as the Elevon 2 because of the outsole rubber that the Elevon 2 built in, this blue here on the outsole, but I do still think that 500 range absolutely in the Arahi 4. Now, the big question, here we go. Mach 3, buy it again? No. Cavu 3, buy it again? No. Oh man, okay, Elevon 2, buy it again? $160? No. Oh, so sad. I hate to be harsh, but like, it's just too expensive. There's other shoes on the marketplace that you can buy in that more, again, like I said, that 140 range rather than the, actually I'll put them on your screen right now that I would put into the same long run category that are closer to that 140 range rather than 160. So sad, but I'm just telling you the truth. Okay, Arahi 4, 130, there you go. Yes, the Arahi 4, the stability shoe, makes the mark for purchasing again in 2020. There you go, the Hoka running shoe lineup of 2020. Now, question of the day, Hoka fans out there, what are you running in right now and why? Like, why do you love that Hoka shoe? And this is an opportunity, everyone, to go, because there's so many, like, I feel like I did pretty good thus in the first quarter of 2020, but there are so many Hoka shoes out there, like the Bondi, that I just haven't had a chance to run in yet. All right, everyone, there you go. That's today's vlog, all about Hoka. I love you. Again, there's many other playlists out there on the channel right now that you can go watch if you want to learn about ASICS, if you want to go learn about Nike, Salomon, Skechers, and next up is going to be Adidas. So I'm working on that playlist right now. All right, we're going to toss it back to, oh man, what did I say? I think we're going to toss it back to, well, if I remember, it's going to be right there. I think I'm going to toss it. Oh yeah, well, I'll do it to the Hoka playlist. There you go. Hoka playlist right there on your screen. You guys rock. All right, everyone. Thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.